Weather pattern for this time of year, we're seeing a wee bit more than just the afternoon showers right now.
I tell you what, where it's raining, it is coming down. Before we get into weather, just wanted a quick shout out for our good friends over there, EA Sports. Boy, you were the hit over there today.
What?
Talking like you.
You weren't even there. And you
I wasn't even there.
How about that? Next year, you're going.
I'm there.
Got that? She's got that. All right, let's take you back outside right now. Satellite and radar, here's what's going on. A lot of rain coming up from the southeastern Gulf of Mexico. And I tell you what, you take a look at these computer models, they're doing a good job of showing you some of the rainfall forecasts for later on this week. And I'm telling you, there is going to be some serious rain here. There already is in some pockets right now, but we're really going to get this rain machine going, we think, on Thursday and Friday. Do have a couple showers and storms. Salt Springs over towards Lynn. Moss Bluffs, just watch the after-school activities up there. Heathrow, Altamont Springs, Winter Park. We've got very heavy rain up and down and now on the eastern side of I-4. You can kind of see how we're just hugging the I-4 corridor now, just kind of bending back more towards the north than the east. Overall flow today southwest to the northeast. You can see over towards Maitland, very heavy rain a short time ago. Back southwest over towards Ocoee, the attractions. Rain letting up now, but there is more to the southwest. There's South Claremont. Back towards the eastern side of the peninsula, Port St. John. I think we have a cam in this area near the Port St. John area, but we've got some pretty impressive rainfall rates right over I-95 at Port St. John. Rain rate there about an inch per hour. This lifting up towards the north now at about 10 miles an hour. You can see there's the I-95 corridor. Just slow down, take it easy, and you'll be in pretty good shape. Not a whole lot of lightning with this cluster, but let's zoom in a little bit closer now. I wanted to show you the Indian River City to Port St. John nook right there. You can see some very heavy rain. Not a whole lot of lightning through this corridor. That's the good news. The bad news is rain rates right around an inch per hour. Now, the other interesting sidebar is what's going on well down to our south. We've got the Yucatan Peninsula here. We've got a broad area of low pressure, and you can see multiple spins ongoing through this corridor. We do believe that there's going to be about a 20% chance for development with this one, and that's low, and there's a good reason for that. When you take a look at those upstairs winds, the wind shear here, pretty high at about 25 to 35 knots, so not a good favorable environment for tropical development, but there is plenty of moisture to go around. You take a look at the computer models, half the camp headed west, half the camp headed to the right. These are the more reliable models, and these are the models we're tending to sync up with here. And if you take a look at some of the rainfall forecasts, this is the GFS US computer model, and all of the models come in anywhere between about 3 to about 6 inches of rain beginning late Wednesday on into early Saturday morning. So as this low tries to organize now over the next couple of days, at the very least, the major concern for us, not so much the wind, but the flooding rain. Some of the conservative models now running 4 to 6 inches of rain as we get you into that window Wednesday night, Thursday, and early Friday morning. Of course, any changes or deviations will be the first to let you know, so do check back in. All right, out the door in the morning, cloudy skies, lunchtime 82, showers and storms getting going. On Wednesday, more of the same, a little bit warmer, maybe a slight downtick in the overall percentage, but the real rain now, Thursday on into Friday, as we watch the Gulf, the flooding concerns will be going up. By the weekend, Jim and Martha, it looks like the temperature is going to go up, but the rain chances are still going to be quite high.
Tony, thanks. Police draw weapons on an